Okay, so now welcome back, and today we get to start the topic of antiderivatives. So what is an antiderivative? Well, you know what a derivative is, right? We've been dealing with derivatives for a long time. We've learned lots of techniques of dealing with antiderivatives. So the question then becomes is, well, if I'm given a function, how do I find the function whose derivative is the given function? In other words, can we take the process of finding a derivative and go the other direction? So, and that's what we call an antiderivative. When we find an antiderivative, we're looking for a function whose derivative gives us a particular function, okay? So, the definition of a derivative then is a function, capital F, is an antiderivative of the function lowercase f if the derivative of capital F equals f of x for all x in the domain of f. Okay, now, for example, if I use, let's say, f of x is equal to, let's do f of x is equal to x cubed, right? So if I take the derivative, right, of f prime of x, so if I take the derivative, that gives me 3x squared, right? Now, that means that f is the antiderivative of 3x squared. So in other words, I could rewrite this another way. I could say, okay, well, I give you the function f of x is equal to 3x squared, then the antiderivative of this would be f of x equal to x cubed, right? Because the derivative of this equals this. Okay, now, is this the only antiderivative? Is this the only function whose derivative will give me 3x squared? No. In fact, I could have that, right? If I take the derivative of that, I'll get this. So this is the antiderivative of f of x. Or what if I choose 5? If I take the derivative of this, that'll give me 3x squared. So that means this is also an antiderivative. In fact, there's an infinite number of antiderivatives of which the derivative of this will give us 3x squared. In fact, this is what we call this a family of derivatives, right? Or a family of antiderivatives. So, in other words, it doesn't matter what constant I put here. This form represents the antiderivative of all functions that will give me 3x squared when I take the derivative of it. So this is the general form of the antiderivative, because we could always stick a c, a constant here, and it's not going to change what the derivative becomes. Okay, so that brings us to the general form. So the theorem one is about the general form of an antiderivative, because we can take any two antiderivatives and we can subtract them and they'll only be different by a constant. So the theorem says that let f, capital F, be an antiderivative of f over an interval I. Then, one, for each constant c, the function capital F of x plus c is also an antiderivative of f over I. Meaning, I can put any constant, I can add or subtract any constant from the antiderivative, and it will still be an antiderivative of f over the integral I. Okay, two, if g is also an antiderivative over of f over I, then there is a constant c for which g of x is equal to f of x plus c over I. In other words, what this is saying is that the most general form of an antiderivative is given by this, where it's going to be f of x plus c. Okay, oops.
Let me do that.
Wait, not what I wanted. This is the most general form, okay, of an antiderivative. Okay. We'll come back and do some examples.